Foxtrot B49 was decommissioned in 1994 and sold into private hands and made into a museum ship. She was put under a new name, U-475 Black Widow, and based in London on the Thames, then in Folkestone for a short time. It was moved to its present location, moored in Strood on the River Medway.
Right, let's go then, folks. It's the old officer's cabin, side to side. Need a life jacket on the boat, folks, because it's summer. Another clock would have been there. Submarine clock. These buttons, look. Don't know what they do. Now I'm dressed up for the occasion, but everything's worn. All the paint's worn off, everything. Yeah, I'm getting the hang of that, you know. Tell you what you do notice, that being orange, you really stand out.
Right.
That's the same as what you saw earlier, really.
Oh, yeah.
It's a voltmeter.
Voltmeter.
That's oxygen, isn't it?
Bottle.
Oh, look at this stuff.
The breathing apparatus.
Oh, look at the rot. That's quite bad to see, actually, all that rot.
It's got rubber, though, isn't it? Just... And some big old stuff.
What's on the back of this door? Can't. Oh, well, it's chained. It's chained.
That's a bit of a rarity, isn't it, to see the actual cable still intact in places.
Yeah, where did you see in one of the rooms that side, there's this big old cable like that,
yeah,
and it's been cut through.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, so yeah. Cable robbing has happened.
Happened in here as well, look, have you seen this?
It's like where the dials were like.
Lots more cables been robbed in here.
Oh, yeah, they're all...
Yeah.
Because
that would have gone all the way along the back there, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it goes along that side, look, all in the ducting.
Oh, right, so everybody nicks it from outside.
Yeah.
See, that side's missing, the other side's still there.
Is that the pistons?
Yeah. I wonder how actually...
Oh, I don't see that. What
I wonder how far down this actually engine goes.
Yeah.
What's in there?
It's pistons, isn't
it?
Nathan? That's the crank at the bottom. Yeah. Your pistons will be up further up.
This is the actual engine.
Right.
Well, that's your big end.
Generator room?
Yeah. I think that's the air intake, isn't it? Here. What did it run on? Diesel?
Yeah.
So is this, would it have backup?
Batteries.
Yeah.
Because you can't use diesel when you're underwater, can you?
No. Exhaust, isn't it?
Go through that hatch.
Oh wow, it looks
still new. So what is that?
There's a big...
It governs it somehow, like turns it up and down.
Oh look, you've got different colour lights, so I guess red is like too much.
Oh, see.
Might be buoyancy devices. A few of them though, isn't there?
It's got to be some...
You know, you can just hear lots of flicking the switches.
There's got to be some fans out there that can decipher Russian.
And yeah.
Give us some idea of what it all is. Because all the plates are still there, aren't they?
Yeah.
It's obviously not buoyancy, it's obviously electric somehow, isn't it? But
probably the battery backup.
No, you're all right.
There was a paper back here somewhere.
Oh my god! In here?
Into the. What's it called? Yeah.
Couldn't! That's crazy.
There's a little
wood falls over beyond the door.
We're about here.
It's like obviously some sort of mechanical flushing thing, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Sure, I thought that might be something to do with it.
It looks like someone's already left stuff in there.
Yeah, it seems. Right, so this is the aft torpedo room.
I still don't quite get how you do.
How'd you fire it?
How'd you get the torpedo? There's not a lot of space.
These are the firing buttons, aren't they? These.
Oh, look. You did miss that, look.
You got this here.
So the torpedoes would have come in here, like the other end.
Right.
So you just had a narrow space to go from the middle.
It's been changed at this end,
yeah,
they might have changed it through the years, maybe.
Yeah.
Might have, when it first opened, it might have been sort of all racks either side, like a U-boat.
Yeah. Wow, there's like a giant spanner there, look.
Christ.
I'm amazed, you know, how much is still on it.
See that?
You're going a bit.
You're going out that way? The emergency escape hatch.
I don't see how, I mean, you said about the rubber bit. I don't quite see how it works.
No, I don't. Because water would get through it, obviously. Of course, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Seep through it.
So it took the handle and stuff off.
I'm not sure I'm directly right, but this is something they used to put down for divers, so they could go out of the submarine. I don't know.
Right, this cover stuff.
It's got a rubber cover, comes down. I don't know if it's true or not, but
right.
That's what it looks like. It's 20 odd years since I've been in here last.
Right.
We had the tour.
Yeah, it looks like.
And they said it's something to do with this comes up or goes down for divers getting in and out.
All right.
Diving bell to be attached, and then they can come into the sub.
That's interesting.
Maybe someone else will know a bit than us.
Yeah. Rubber stuff.
Yeah.
Alright.
You've got green, red. I assume it's...
Batteries?
Yeah.
Is that to do with batteries? I'm sure someone will tell us.
Safe.
I'm earthed. Earthed wise. It's a big light.
I wonder if you really needed quite so many gauges and stuff.
It's all overdone, isn't it?
I think so. Look at the ceiling.
Seal that compartment.
It's quite good, isn't it?
That is amazing.
Take some undoing though, won't it? Because you've got to tighten all them up.
Yeah. I suppose if there's a fire, it has to be 100% sealed.
If there's a fire, I wouldn't really want to be on it.
Down there. Look, there you go. But lift it up. There you go.
She's still here.
Take your arm out.
Is that a picture or what?
Huh?
You still
there
without
a yellow.
Yeah.
Stupid
Hello.
I'm sending you a message. Yeah.
This is all good this gear, isn't it?
I've just fixed this because it's broken. No. That's what you call a phone.
Proper phone, yeah. Check that mobile phone out, folks.
I like the Morse code.
Where's that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It actually sounds cool.
Not very good if you're hiding.
Oh, there's another. I've got a submarine clock, and that's, it's got the same dial thing like that. Hooks in.
See, that's probably why there isn't any in here, because they've all been sold on eBay.
Yeah, they fetch a few hundred. And Chris has got the art to it now. Run and jump for it, can't you?
Yeah. I'm not jumping for it.
There it is.
It's not larded up enough.
It's in here, yeah.
No, I wasn't just going to reply. I wasn't going to reply.
Yes, that's how it's done.
Oh, and then
do you want to have a go, Chris?
Then you can come back.
No. I'll film you doing it.
do you want to be in the short?
Just getting the head knocked in by accident. Right, ready?
No, that's a fail, isn't it? That's one for the IKS bloopers. What is it?
You want to have a hangover on the stuff?
Aye.
You want to have a hangover working on it?
Nah.
Certainly not.
That person way.
So that's the old compass.
Yeah.
Gyro compass. There's some cables that's covered in sort of.
It all depends what goes through them, I suppose. It's
fine.
Yeah.
Guess you can talk to different parts of the ship.
Yeah.
It's got red stuff in it.
Yeah.
That's depth, isn't it?
Water level, I think, for like. Oh. Maybe. I don't know.
Oh, wow.
So as the boat rolls or whatever the water.
Where's the depth counter anyway?
I don't know, it's one of these in Russian.
You'd be looking for fathoms. Is it gonna,
It's going to be quite big, isn't it? Is it going to be like the biggest knob?
It's geared
biggest
on.
Leave us here.
There you go.
You alright?
Did you get this?
What's that?
Phone home.
Oh yeah, I see that.
Yeah, so.
That's a mobile phone, that one, folks.
Can you got
trigger happy.
Obviously these bits to.
Yeah, I can't come into work today.
Must be muffle out the the noise and everything like that.
I think the door's gonna be shut first, doesn't it?
Watch the headphones. Here, Darren does it to her. Aussie.
This one's a bit different because you're coming up.
You could be a Russian sailor.
Aye.
Russian sailor.
Hello, sailor.
You just have to be small and this will keep open mind.
How small you'd have to be to work in it?
Well, I don't know.
Well, should you just go around bashing your head all the time? Or do you just learn to duck?
I suppose you get used to it, don't you?
Table.
It's all original stuff, isn't it? That's the amazing thing about it.
That's what I'm saying. It's even down if you say nice. Look, original life jackets.
Oh, put there especially for you, mate.
Do you think it'll work? Stop me sinking. I didn't get it on.
I think that's probably out of date now.
No? Oh, there we go. Look at that.
Can't even get dressed.
Yeah, do you think it's had its day then?
Yeah, there's hooks on the other end. Yeah, there they are.
Wouldn't you put that on in a hurry though, would you?
Chris is a Russian sailor, putting his life jacket on.
We wouldn't be put on in a hurry.
I would be worried it would unbutton.
Huh?
Unbutton.
Hello, it doesn't even cover like my stomach.
Crazy, mate.
See, don't we fit me?
Right, that's all right. Right, show us where the forward torpedo room is in, Chris.
Other end.
Right, go on then. Just keep walking.
Oh. As in, into everything. Yeah?
Yeah.
So you can see how hard it is to film whilst negotiating the captains.
We hear of compartments that are located under the floor that we've been walking on, near the aft of the sub. We had to check these rooms out.
Oh Christ, that's a big ratch, isn't it? I'm going down that one.
Oh right, yeah, cool.
Tom's just fit down some tiny little one.
Ow!
Ow!
Yeah, what's it like down there, Chris?
Small.
He's going down.
Oh, that's an anticlimax.
That sounds a bit claustrophobic.
Yeah, obviously.
Oh no, look, there's loads of space here.
Yeah, mate.
That's cycle in, isn't it?
What's going on?
I don't know, we'll find out. Like, not much, but Ian will probably find some random other hole.
Has anybody brought lard? That's not that tight.
Brought that next one down?
Yeah, it's tight enough.
It wasn't too bad getting in, right. Getting out was a bit more of a pain.
Right, let's have a look.
Or just stick the camera down it.
Oh yeah.
That's more worried about jumping in. Yeah. Jumping in and that being it. Just, if you top your crypt, you don't want to slide yourself into it.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Nowhere.
It's a bit of an anticlimax, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, I...
it's probably service. It's, you got things you can unscrew. You can unscrew the sidings.
Oh, yeah, I saw that, yeah. You did say you can get into the tanks.
Oh.
See? They've been doing some welding.
So we might need to find out how they're doing. Do you need Dan?
I should do alright.
No, you got in there.
Alright, Chris.
No, no inspiration, buddy. No, f***ing. Leave him behind.
Bye.
That pub is a bit of a different story. Okay, alright.
Alright. Cheers.
There's a ladder behind you.
Yeah, I see, yeah. Thanks.
Bit squeezed, isn't it?
Just a bit. Because it's like an egg-shaped style thing. It's bloody hard. You can't twist properly.
I thought you was claustrophobic, then.
Hey?
I thought you was claustrophobic.
Nah, it depends what location. It depends if it's collapsing, doesn't it?
Does that go anywhere?
I didn't have the balls to start climbing over on top of all these
things.
Watch those screens.
Jesus.
Well, shall I take it off your hands, Chris?
What?
No, the other Chris.
Yeah. Chris 2.
Yeah, Chris number 2. Cheers.
Chris.
Well, that's a dead. That's a.
It's a bit dodgy, isn't it?
Just a bit. There's a lot of oil down here.
Yeah?
Yeah, hell of a lot. Right at the bottom of the boat we are.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
There's another hatch here.
There's hatches everywhere.
cool. So we're underwater right now. Try now!
Pipe,
yeah.
Oh, right.
Oh, he fell in then? He fell down there.
Oh my god, what the f?
Jesus. There's a ladder in. Easy way out. Can you take that again, Chris? Can I be a pain? Or something?
That actually looked like a, that looks like a long way down.
It's oil at the bottom. This looks like a. Right, you coming this way, folks?
I was going to say, you ain't going to need that, you're an experienced veteran, aren't you?
Veteran, yeah,
it's not very bad, mate.
Right, where am I now?
Oh, back here.
Oh, there's someone else.
Oh,
Tom.
It's twins.
Do you not find any other hatches?
What hatch is this way? There's stuff
this goes way. Off over that stuff direction.
I think you'd be crawling around. You can get under that bit, but it just leads to under there.
You'd be crawling around on your belly and you get well going. You see the side of the sub where it goes under.
Right. So that's basically the bottom then,
isn't it? Yeah,
You can get right round the back there, but it's very, very tight. Very tight. Bugger being an engineer on a submarine.
Located opposite the very small submarine kitchen was another hatch down, and what was down there fascinated us.
Right. Wow.
Good down there.
Yeah, it's quite big. It's bigger than the other ones.
Worth it?
Yeah. This is, yeah,
that was in USSR.
That was in the,
That's it? Yeah. It's only a paper one.
Oh yeah, USSR. Amazing. Speaker there.
That's doors.
Another radio for communication.
There's doors everywhere,
isn't
it?
Yeah.
Wow. You have more dials and knobs.
I'm not sure if Darren has actually. Whoa, is this refrigerators? Yeah. Is this where all the food would have been stored for the submarine? Wow.
Feels a bit musty down here.
Yeah. I never thought about that actually.
Can you stand that door up? Why did I? It's just wood and felt round it, isn't it?
Yeah. Look above you.
It's the old fridge. Yeah, it is.
Probably much better than the fridge we got at home.
He did say it was a refrigerator section.
I can hear Darren.
Yeah.
Are you going in there, Chris?
Huh?
You coming in?
Yeah.
that goes to the ballast tanks. That's crazy.
Look at that, look. But that's been there since like
Cold War. Screw one, huh? So that's the fridge. And look, it's got even got a door on the outside.
Yeah. There's like spare light fittings.
Oh, you see this? It's got the temperature gauges.
Huh?
Temperature gauges for the fridge.
Oh, wow. So would you have to pop down here every time you wanted something out of the fridge?
I suppose, yeah. The kitchen's just above, isn't it, I think?
Yeah.
It's got a lock on it as well, stop...
Fridge raiders.
Yeah, to stop the, people who want more food coming down. Even the light fittings in here, it's got springs on it. What are these food canisters? Did you see this?
What, the metal ones?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not too liking it in here.
Hey?
I'm not too keen on down here.
Why?
It's a bit...
What, claustrophobic?
Dusty and...
We've been the worst places. Attached. Been the worst places.
Everything's crammed in, isn't it?
Yeah. Right.
It's been a nightmare to work on anything, though.
It's been a bloody nightmare. It's got some sort of gauge here.
Don't you love our technical opinions? It's like there's a gauge here.
Some sort of gauge. Does it go round?
No. Well, it stops there. You've been on those cages and stuff. Get through this. You've been climbing over the machinery. Look at the wear on that.
Yeah.
People have leaned on it. I'd like to climb over there. I suppose the majority of stuff you wouldn't have to touch unless there was a problem. And a lot of it, I suppose, it's more isolation, isn't it?
Yeah. So if you stop something's leaking,
you can isolate virtually everything.
Yeah. Got a bell
like
thing
in. Like you see it in films, don't you? Yeah, you know, spring a leak and they start twisting knobs and stopping it.
Yeah.
Speaker.
Yeah, and a bell.
You shout down, oh, I forgot to tell you, I want more bacon.
Yeah.
Whatever you have. Yeah, I must say, them fridges are absolutely amazing.
I know. I reckon I've probably been in there four times and I never really take a lot of details.
Yeah, haven't you?
See what the food canister's still in there.
A couple of them, yeah.
I suppose the food would have gone inside them, yeah.
So which other areas did you go down?
Near the engine, mainly. Get some work done down here.
Engine room.
These batteries, I believe, these put in the comment section, folks, it's had to do with batteries.
Generator room?
Yeah, for the, can't use diesel, like Chris said earlier, about under the water, because there's nowhere for the exhaust to come out. And that's it, folks.
When Russia sold the submarine, they made sure it was decommissioned so that it could not be used as a weapon of war against them.